Brittany, and I am in the car on the way to, where am I going? Oh, I just left my 6-week checkup. Definitely have a video about that. But now I'm on the way to the WIC office and need to switch out my breastfeeding pump for a personal use pump. So, yeah. But the 6-week checkup is kind of sad, guys, and I'll tell you why. A little bit later, but yeah, so I have 3 appointments today. I had my I was actually late for my 6-week checkup. It was at 9. I didn't get there till 10. And then I have a WIC appointment, and I have I have to go see my hand specialist at 2:50. It's 11:40. Well, it's not 11:47. That clock is like 10 minutes fast. But yeah, so I'm just on my way. You know, I'm kind of driving one hand. So I don't have my camera mount in the car, but my phone mount. Sorry. So yeah. Oh my God, this person does not know how to. Okay, you merge. You don't stop. You merge. Oh, I have a slight road rage. But so yeah, I'm just gonna give you guys a quick peek at this, and see you in a little bit. Yeah. This is weird. This person is like standing. I don't want to turn the camera around because I think they might. This person's like standing in front of the car. Like, I don't even know. So, all right, let's go. Stop sign. It is so hood like over here. I don't even understand. Like, we like, and it was right outside a military base, and it's just like the most ratchet area right here. It's just crazy. I don't even understand. But, well, actually, I kind of understand a little bit, but I'm not gonna elaborate on that. Anyway, so yeah. By the way, yeah, WIC is not just for, like, I guess, WIC is, like, for women, infants, and children, so a lot of people assume that it's, like, oh my God, it, you know, you're on food stamps or whatever, but it's women, infants, and children, and basically, it's kind of part of the food assistance program, but it's not food stamps. They make sure you never confuse the two, especially when you're talking to, like, WIC counselors. Pretty much, even if you're married, because in Virginia, it's basically all military. It's the Navy, the Marines, the Army, the Air Force, all in Virginia because it's right by D.C. And it's like one of their main ports. So a lot of military families, believe it or not, actually are on WIC. And people assume that the military has a lot of money. I've been a military dependent for a very long time. And until I was like 22 or 23, I could be a military dependent until I was out of college. So I think it's 23. And, you know, we didn't have WIC. My parents didn't even know that they could qualify for WIC when, you know, being that they were in the military, because they thought, oh, you had to be extremely low income. But they have increased, like, your income eligibility. Basically, it's based off household amount, like anything else, and combined income. So I was like, and then I worked for a very, Jeremy and I both worked for a very reputable cell phone company, and we're making some, you know, a nice living, I'll say. And I was like, people at my job are like, oh, you're pregnant, go apply for your WIC. And I'm like, what? You know, I'm like, why would, I was like, you're on WIC? They're like, yeah. Like, girl, yeah. I'm like, what? You know, like, why would I, you know, and I went in there, they're like, oh yeah, you qualify. I said, huh? So, I don't know, it is a little interesting to find that out. It's amazing what you don't know, so, but I've been lucky that I've been getting, like, a lot of coupons from Infomail. Like, I can buy two things for $30, and if you guys know, like, one can be anywhere from $20 to $25 for one thing of Infomail or Similac. So to get 2 for $30 is like a pretty good deal. Plus, you know, you have the store. If you like Food Lion or some type of grocery store shopping, they have specials, so you can definitely get the value cards of those. But it is so funny when people see you vlogging in the car and they're like, what the hell? But yeah, I'm hungry. I am so hungry. Have you guys' appetite changed since you've had babies? Like, do you feel like you're just not eating enough? Or not that, because I don't really have an appetite, but when I'm hungry, I am like starving. I go from 0 to 60 like really, really quick. But and I drive past an IHOP as we speak. So yeah, I'm gonna head home, pick up some lunch in my Madea voice, and yeah. I was telling guys I had some issues with my urethra. They pulled it out. He gave me this stuff called, it's like estrogen, and you kind of put it on your urethra area to kind of heal it. He just gave me a sample. I just use it. You just use it twice a week. And then I also got some information on my Mirena. So he was like, I don't know how long you plan on waiting before you have another baby, but I was like, not for a while. And I don't know about y'all, but it seems like ever since I had a baby, all people can talk about is the next time I'm going to have a baby. Hello, I just gave birth to a bowling ball. Like, are you serious? So, yeah. Okay, guys, just turn in front of me like I don't have a life. All right. Okay, so I'm gonna go to McDonald's, I think. I haven't had McDonald's in like months. I'm not a big McDonald's person. Only thing I liked from there was their frappes. I think I want one of those. No, I don't. Okay. This is like the dumbest thing I've ever seen, having someone outside taking your order. Good morning, YouTube. It's 6:49 a.m. and it's Friday. Oh my gosh, it's Friday, December 1st. I think it's December 1st. Yeah, December 1st. It's almost time to count down for Christmas. Hanukkah, Kwanzaa. I think I covered them all. Just in case. Yeah. Despite the smile on my face, last night was not a good night. Like, at first, Xavier was doing a lot of napping during the day. Like, he wouldn't go down, like, cat napping. He normally will sleep for about 2 hours, 2 to 3 hours, in his normal naps. But I would let him, he'd be so sleepy. I'd lay him down. He would sleep for, like, 30 minutes and wake up and be up for, like, an hour. And then sleep for another 30 minutes and be up for an hour. So he did a lot of cat napping. So he was fussy pretty much all day. And then last night, you know, I took a shower with him. Well, no, earlier that day, I want to say 9 or 10, I took a shower with him to kind of relax him. Because he likes, when he takes a shower, he's relaxed. I give him a nice, you know, warm bottle. Because it helps him sleep. Pediatrician said try a warm bottle. Also may help with hiccups. And constipation, for the record. Just going to throw that in there. But he fell asleep. I rocked him to sleep. He fell asleep. And he was like, sleep. As soon as I laid him down, he woke up. And that's about 11. And then from, you know, he kind of lay there for a minute. And then he started fussing. And he started fussing from like 11:30 until 1. And for no, like, nothing was wrong with him. He wasn't wet. He didn't have a fever. He wasn't hungry, obviously, because he just ate. You know, he wasn't hot, he wasn't cold, he just fussed, and I was so exhausted, I thought I wanted to cry. Like, I officially almost had my first breaking point. Like, I can deal with crying, that doesn't bother me, it's just when I know there's nothing wrong with him, that's when I kind of get like, what am I supposed to do? Like,
It's hard. It's really hard, especially at 6 in the morning when you don't have all of your, well, 2 in the morning, you really don't have all your bearings, you're tired, and then, you know you have a trip to go on later today. We're going to see his grandmother, so, yeah. I talked to Jermaine, like, you know, gave me some encouraging words, they'll be okay, you know, but, and then you don't want to really voice, like, these type of thoughts, because people, you're going to think, people might think you're a bad mother, but yeah, being a parent is hard. Like, I see why some people cannot be full-time stay-at-home moms, because there are going to be those moments where you just kind of need a release, and there's, like, at 2 or 1, 2 in the morning, there's nowhere you can go. You can't take the baby out to go for a drive. Because even the car, he'll go to sleep in the car. But I was just so tired, and he was so fussy. And I think it's hard to deal with really, like, a really, really fussy baby. Like, he doesn't have colic. It's not colic because, he's able to calm down. He didn't do it. He wasn't, like, crying on end. He was like whiny. It was like little, like he was just kind of whiny.
He's almost 7. Jermaine gets off at 11. He should be here about 11:30, and we're leaving around 12 to go to North Carolina. I think I'll try to sleep in the car. But if Xavier sleeps, I'll sleep in the car. If he doesn't, then he'll be tired. So yeah, this is my. Please don't judge me section on the vlog. I think, guys, if you have any ideas or suggestions, especially for the new moms that have been moms before, I know each baby is different, so kind of, you know, what do you guys do in those situations? Is it normal to feel kind of like defeated sometimes? Yeah, that's it.
It's Xavier's first trip. I can't even see him. There he is. He's going to grandma.
Lordy, I hate this bird.
Say what? Are you excited? Our baby is finally riding around and getting it.
He was born.
Exactly. And she lives so close, but she was sick, so she couldn't come up, and she was very sad. I'm excited for another reason, too. You made it to 6 weeks. It's been a long 10 months ever. Yeah. I want to get me some peach Ciroc. Was it peach that we had last time? I like the peach one because red berry is still kind of strong. Like, peach is strong, but it's not as, like, taste-wise. It's like, remember you mixed the peach with the lemon, the tea, and it was like peach tea kind of? And I was taking it down, like, I could do regular shots with those. That's fine. I'll take that, too. What are you going to mix it with? Okay. Oh, yeah. It's 6 weeks. Okay. Well, we're going to keep driving because it's hot today, too. It's like 60 degrees outside. Lord.